Hello, everyone, and welcome to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. We're glad you're tuned in. We want to give a shout out to our friends at Southern Oregon PBS, KTVL, KDRV, and the Dove Network. Thank you for hosting us on your station. In the Medford School District, we have one shared vision, and that we believe that all are learning, and learning is for all. And what better place to do that than right here on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
Hi, I'm Mr. Olinghouse. I'm an elective teacher over here at Hedrick Middle School. And I teach a lot of different subjects, including music and digital art and things like that. And today we're going to mix some music using a website called Audio Tool. Now, this lesson is really meant for seventh graders and up. And the reason why I say that is because a lot of sixth graders won't be able to, and under won't be able to access this website. So this is for you older kids out there today. The website we're going to use today, audiotool.com, is a German-based website. I'm just going to type in Audio Tool. You can put in the .com if you want, and you'll see it pops up right off the bat. We've got free music software. I'm going to click on there. And up here at the very beginning, I can enter the studio or log in. I'm just going to hit Enter Studio, and it'll prompt me to log in. In this case, I'm just going to log in with my Google account. This is like your MSD549C account. So if you have any kind of Gmail account, or you can go ahead and create your own. And then up here, now that we're logged in, if I hit Enter Studio, it takes us into a really fascinating place. This is a place where we can create our own digital beats. You can mix samples. There's all kinds of things we can do. This has a new project here, or an open project, or you can remix other people's projects. So today I'm just going to start a new project. And it starts off with this little amp here in the middle. And that amp, we don't need to do much with it. It's already set at -3 decibels. That's plenty good for what we're going to need. It's hooked up to a mixing board, a 16-channel mixer. And we're going to use this maybe a little bit today. But mostly what I'm going to focus on is how to, and let's say I'm going to get rid of this little X here, is how to use these over here. These are our devices. There is a sampling machine here. I can just click and drag it in. There is a Roland 808 synthesizer. I can double click and it brings it in. And I can use, in this case, I'm using a mouse, but you can use a trackpad for all this as well. If you scroll up and down on the trackpad, you can zoom in and out on your workspace here. There's a synthesizer here that's also a drum machine. It's just got a little bit different drum sounds to it. I'll show you those in a minute. And then there's also synthesizers that we can get into. I won't touch the baseline one, though there is a really cool pulverizator, however you say that. And this one allows you to mix three different channels simultaneously. These are called oscillators. And it looks like I'm really low resolution. That's actually just the resolution of the website. In order to be able to zoom in and out like this, they keep everything kind of low res. That way it doesn't bog down because it's all web-based. This, everything you can do on this, you can do on a Chromebook. I'm using a Mac today, but you can definitely use a Chromebook for this. The Heisenberg here is another synthesizer. I really like this one. We'll get to play with that one a bit today, as well as the Tone Matrix here. The Tone Matrix is by far the simplest of them. And you see I can just click and make swirling patterns on there. And what that does is it turns on little audio switches. I can clear that out up here. I'm going to clear it right now. But let's go ahead and click a few of these. And what you're going to hear is this is kind of like playing black notes on the piano. If you just did the black notes on the piano, you would get what's called a pentatonic scale. And that's what the synthesizer is preset for, is a couple of octaves of pentatonics. I'm going to hit play up here to start it. And you can hear that. Sounds like a cute little harp or something like that. But there's something that's happening down here. You see this white line that's moving when I hit play? That white line is part of our timeline. That's our indicator of where we are. The bigger dark lines are bar lines. That's how many bars you have, or measures. Now, we can create a loop up here. We can turn our loop on or off. And what it does is it automatically defaults to a four-measure loop. You can always extend this if you need to, but I'm going to bring it back to a four-measure loop there. I'm going to go ahead and turn those off. I'm just clicking and dragging over the top of them. That's another way you can clear them. What's great about this little synthesizer, though, is you can actually create digital art with it. So let's say I just wanted to write a little message here. Here we go. Okay. We can hear what the word hi sounds like. And it's just repeating it every measure. So each one of these little boxes in here going up is moving up one pitch in the pentatonic scale. Each beat move, or each box moving to the right, is actually a 16th note in a measure. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's, we got 8 of our 16th notes. So we're halfway through the measure. 9, 10, 11, 12, and so on and so forth. So you actually have time that's measured going across your x-axis while pitch is on your y-axis. Okay, if we wanted to translate something like that to the timeline, I'm just gonna pick a few fun random notes. I don't know, we'll see how this sounds. Okay, if I like that, I can hit stop. My space bar is my stop button, or I can click stop up here. If I hit stop up here though, watch what happens to this white line when I click stop. It goes back to the very beginning. And that allows us to reset where we are in our timeline. You can also click and drag here where the little numbers are, where the bar measures are. They're really tiny on there, a little hard to see. My one of few criticisms I have of this website, some things are a little low resolution, hard to see, but it does a great job. And again, everything on here is free. So you can get in here by right-clicking the border of the synthesizer anywhere on the right, right-click. You can copy pattern to note track. And if I like that, it created this pattern down here in the timeline. So if I go up here and create a new pattern, I could click on one of these boxes to get a new pattern. I could always come back to that one if I wanted to. I can then come down here and we'll hear just this play. Okay. Now there's a few things I can do with this, but there's something that's important to know. If you don't make your synthesizer go blank, watch what happens now. I'm going to leave the synthesizer on while this is on the timeline. So we hear it play. Ah, but that's actually not the timeline playing that. That's actually the synthesizer that's now playing beyond it. Okay, so if we clear that out, we have this little sample now. We can extend the sample by clicking on the edge. You see how it turns into a little arrow and you can click and drag it over. And now we can have that same effect, but now it's permanently here in the timeline. What's great about the timeline is anything in your timeline, you can go up to project, and you can save these, by the way, and you can give them names, like I'm gonna just call this a simple tune. Woo, if I could type, simple tune. And it gives you copyright options on here. Yes, you can copyright your stuff. I'm gonna save that file. You see how it's compiling, uploading. And then here's the fun part. I can actually come up here, I can publish this little tiny sample right now. And this little simple tune, if I hit publish now, I did that by going up to project and going to publish. You see it's downloading it, it's rendering it, encoding it, creating a snapshot, and then uploading it. And then you can actually go into your account in Audio Tool and download this sample now as an MP3 file, which is what most audio that you listen to on your phone is typically a streaming MP3. It's MP3s that are being broadcast through the internet that you're streaming from a website. But that's the same one. If you download music on your phone, it's downloaded typically in an MP3 format or something similar to it. All right, so we were able to create a little note track here, and then we're able to publish it as well into an MP3. And if you want to get into those, we can go up here to our account. Here I am, the band director, and you can see some of the things that I've followed other people here on. Here's a song a student made from a little while back. And now I have this simple tune. If I click on that, I can listen to it through the website. But if I click on down here, a simple tune down here, I'm gonna pause it. I can actually come over here. You see where it says download? This is where I can now download this. So there's a whole social media component to this website. And this is also why it's for older students, is this is a website that uses users from all over the world. So there's, you'll hear music from all over the world. So like YouTube parents, it's a good thing. You wanna monitor what your students do on a website like this, just like you would on YouTube. All right, let's get back into the studio. We'll load that up here for just a moment. All right, now I can open that project. You can see I've been playing around with this for a little bit. There we go. Here's a different one that I made just a little bit ago. And let's see, I'm gonna go through and find just a little bit of a smaller loop. I'm gonna do a 4-measure loop on here. I have a little larger sample that I programmed in. What I used here was a Heisenberg. And with a Heisenberg, when you bring one of them in, if you click and drag one of these in, you'll see it created Heisenberg 1 here. I already had one in there. I can double click on the timeline. And in there, I can double click on that little sample that I just created. And you can program this in. I could click and drag. I come up here to the border of my timeline. I can drag this up. You can make it full screen if you need to. And this gives you access to a MIDI keyboard, basically. And you can come through here. You can hear the individual pitches. Or you can double click on the timeline and create something. Right? So what's cool about this, though, what I'm about to show you, if you don't like what you got, you can hit select it and hit delete, and deletes it off. Here's one that I made earlier. You might recognize it. I made it a little lower in pitch. And what I have is just a 4-bar repeat. It's only going up to this point right here and then repeating. If I let it go on or turn the looping off, okay. Well, as nice as that song is, I'm just going to bring it back to that 4-bar loop. We can play around with that. Up here, you can see I was able to extend the timeline, but I can pull this back. And then even if I loop this out, it'll still loop just these 4 bars here. And then it has 4 bars of silence. If you pull that back out, now you can hear the other content again. So this little line below on the other side does the almost the opposite thing. It'll take just this here, and then the timeline up here will start repeating it. So it'll look like this. And now you're going to hear this same segment played here. And there you go. It's something different now. So there's some things you can do to play around with segments in your timeline. You can shorten stuff up. You can also repeat things. So let's say I wanted to go through here. I'm going to zoom out just a little bit on my timeline here. Let's say I really wanted to repeat this sample over on this side. I could take all of this here, highlight it, and delete it. I could then take all of this. Here's just one more way to do the same thing. I'm going to hold down Control on a Chromebook or a Command on a Mac, and I'm going to drag this over. And let's hear what it sounds like now. If I take this whole thing, I'm going to transpose it up. Let's go up just maybe a half step. There we go. Oh, maybe I transpose that up a whole step in this case. So we can do that same thing. So I did that by, again, holding down Control, clicking and dragging, and create a duplicate. You could even create a parallel if you wanted to, a little parallel file to it. We can hear what this sounds like now. Now it'll be in parallel fifths. Or parallel fourths, rather. So you can get some interesting effects just playing with the piano roll and the timeline. All right, let's go back out. I'm going to get out of the timeline here for a little bit. And yes, you can totally hide it and then bring it back up if you want. I'll zoom back out. Let's play with timbre just a little bit. I'm going to use the same sample that we were just doing. And I'm going to bring it back to a 4-bar loop, and I'll start looping it. But I'm going to change the timbre now, or how it sounds, inside the Heisenberg. So I'm going to click on this oscillating waveform. And there's lots of options. And what I realized just now is I created a second one, so I'll delete that one. I just clicked on it and hit delete. I'm actually going to go down here and edit this one, because it's the one where you're hearing the sound from. There we go, that little oscillating waveform. And as I cycle through these, you'll hear the sound change until you find one that you like. Some of them get really annoying sounding. Pretty bad stuff. We can go back to our normal one. Okay, so there's a few options there inside the Heisenberg that they're built in. You'll find those types of things all over the place in this program. Little tiny switches. Let's see if we can change the glide this time. change tuning, and I'm clicking and dragging up and down. There we go. I'll get rid of the glide. So we got a little lower pitch going. There we go. All sorts of interesting things. If you don't like what you did, you can always go Control Z and undo things and get it back to the original. All right. Next, let's jump in and look at one of the drum synthesizers. This right here is a Roland 808. So you'll find it over here in your devices, this little synthesizer. And this is its little synthesizer that came after it, the 909. We'll come in here, and what we're going to do, I'm actually going to come down here and hit this little white dot, and that mutes it. So now I don't hear anything. Up here, I'm going to turn on this drum machine by clicking on beat one here. Now, this is not like beat one, beat two, beat three. This is actually more like one and two and three and four and, or you could think of this as 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. So you get the 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Orange is beat one, dark orange. Light orange is beat two. Yellow is beat three. And white is beat four. Let's go ahead and turn one of these on and hear what it sounds like. You hear that low bass frequency. If you're listening on like a laptop or a Chromebook that doesn't have good speakers, it's going to be hard to hear this. It's good to throw in headphones. There you go. And if you can't hear it too well, we could always come over here. We can see that our switch here is, we can follow our cable. It's plugged into number one over here, and we can see it moving over here. Well, it's maxed out on its volume, but we could turn up the low. But then you see these little red dots. That means it's peaking. When it's peaking, we also call this clipping. It's distorting the audio. So you can only turn it up so loud before it starts turning ugly. Okay. Let's get a little better beat here. Okay. We were working just now in the bass drum. We can also go over to the snare drum. And I just clicked on that little red dot up here. It's hard to read, but it does say snare drum right here. You have low toms, high toms, rim shots, hand claps, cowbells, cymbals, open hats, and closed hi-hats. So on the snare drums, I'm going to add in some backbeat, beat two and beat four. I'm going to slow it down a little bit. I'll click on our BPM, and I'll bring it back down to maybe 120. A little more laid back. Let me switch over to our closed hi-hat over here. See that little red dot? So you can switch between them by just clicking on them. And let's add a little hi-hat. There you go. Now, if you like what you hear there, you can always stop it. Come up here, hit stop. You can use the space bar, but the space bar won't reset your timeline down here. So hitting the stop button will. And we can copy this to the note track. We'll go copy pattern to note track, and you see it created down here. And I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to extend that out to the four bars. Now, what's interesting, this synthesizer is still playing, so I'm going to reset it now. I'm going to hit this red button, and it resets everything. It turned off everything in that synthesizer. But notice what happens if I delete the synthesizer. If I delete the synthesizer, we lose our audio. So do keep the synthesizer even if you turned everything off. I go Control Z, bring it back. Let's go ahead and turn it back on with our original Heisenberg. There we go. We could always kick that beats per minute up. Clicking and dragging upwards. You can go all the way up pretty fast. You can even get up to about 1,000 beats per minute. Let's pull that back. Here's about 120 again. Good. Let's add another layer to this. Let's get into sampling. So with sampling, you can do a few cool things here. You have samples up here. You have looping samples and one-shot samples. So looping samples allow you to get in here. We can check different looping samples. This is like big, long segments. You can click on them, and it'll play a preview for you. Oh, okay, not so bad. I like that one. I'm gonna pull that one in and because I think I'll use it. I'm just clicking in, dragging it in, and it hooked it to my 16-channel mixer. So down here, I now have this big old sample. Well, that's way longer than four bars. So what I think I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pull my four bars over and I'm gonna put it starting at the fifth bar. So we got about four bars of that cool snare intro. And I'll extend my timeline out to nine bars now for the looping. So we can now take a look and hear what it sounds like. You can see it working up here. Okay. So a few little silly things we can do there. Looping samples are fantastic. There's all kinds of looping samples, all the way from jazz and hip hop to you name the genre, it's in here. Yeah, there you go, a little saxophone. I'm not so sure if that would go with what we have, so I think I'll pass on that one. But it's great because you have all sorts of different samples that you can hit in there. One-shot samples are a little bit different. One-shot samples, I switched over. Here's our looping samples. Here's our one-shot samples. One-shot samples are just a single sound. They can be short sounds or long sounds, but nonetheless, they are just one single sound. Let me go back over to our devices real quick. We'll click on here, up here. So we were on samples, now we're on devices. And we're gonna pull over this, I don't know what they call this, it's a Machiniste drum synthesizer. We'll pull this in. What this does is it allows us to mix samples. So we'll go back to our samples up here in the upper right. And let me kick in, let's pull in a kick drum. And I'm just gonna play that on beats one. Let's see, we'll put in on the offbeat of beat two, and then we'll have it hit on beat four again. Nice kind of standard drum beat. I'm gonna mute some of my other stuff that I've been working on in my timeline. There we go. You can turn these on and off. But sometimes simpler is better, so I'm gonna pull it back a little bit. And we'll leave it there. Let's add in a clap. We'll hit that on big beat two and big beat four. Okay, here's a little hi-hat here. Pull this in. Okay, and now we can take this whole thing, if we like what we have, we can right-click it anywhere where there's not a button, because if you right-click a button, you get something different. Right-click where there's not a button, and we're just gonna create a pattern track. But before I do that, if I do that right now, it'll put it right here wherever that white bar is in my timeline. So I'm gonna hit stop first, then pull it up, then copy pattern to note track. Let me pull my time up, line up a little more. And you'll see there's our little sample right there. You can continue editing it in here. You'll see our hi-hat right there. The middle line is our snare. And then the bottom is the kick drum or bass drum. So this is just one more way that you can pull in samples as well. I'm gonna go ahead and delete what we got. What I wanna show you is you can actually start with somebody else's project. And so we're gonna come over here. And remember how I mentioned there was a student who had only, he'd created a file here. We're gonna actually remix his file. His file is called I'm Only 13, So Give Me a Break. And it sounds, I'll play it here in a little bit for you. But what I do wanna show you is I can actually download this one, but I can also remix this track. So when I hit remix, it allows me to pull it in. And let's see what he did to create this. All right, it's loading up the remix. Okay, so here we have, I'm only 13, so give me a break. Let's go ahead and take a listen here, as well as look through our timeline. So you can see the timeline is actually quite extensive. And there's also a lot of things that are not used in it. But up here, we see there's still quite a bit of content in here. All right. There's a few synthesizers, lots of samples. In fact, it looks like most of this down here is built off of samples. All right, we'll hit play. Give it a little sweep, little bass drum hits. Got this little loop that's continuing on here. There's a big sweep about to hit. As well as a snare drum that was custom built. There it goes, big hit. Okay, so now we have this rising trance theme. This seems like our main theme here that he put together. We pulled these all from samples from the website. The dark, we don't know how we got here in the sky. Like Magnus torn apart, you don't know why you come back every time. Like planets. A little repetition. Repetition never hurt with music. Usually when you create music, you want to have something new and something different in order to make it successful. So we have some familiar themes here, but how it's mixed together is what creates it new. Some splashes in there. Looks like we're about to have something change. Ooh, a big bass hit, big drop out of everything. And now a reprisal. Like Magnus torn apart, you don't know why you come back every time. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed this little introduction to Audio Tool. Please remember, this is for seventh graders and older, because it does have community content in there. Parents, you want to monitor students' use, as always, on any Chromebook, because you never know what they're going to be able to come across if they're unmonitored on the internet. We have lots of things blocked already, but do always stay aware and cautious of what your students are doing. Stay informed as parents. That's really important for us. This Audio Tool program, please keep in mind that you can save your files and then come back to them. You can also publish them as MP3s, which you could then download onto a phone. You could make your own phone ringer, for example. You could have your own call tone, that type of stuff. Play around with it. Have fun and enjoy your time on that Chromebook, because it's actually capable of pretty interesting things. All right, for everybody here at MSD TV, I hope you enjoy.
Thanks for tuning in to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. Medford School District is a place where all are learning, and learning is for all.
My name is Stella, and I'm in fifth grade.
Tell me about the school board. What do you know about a school board and what a school board does?
I think it makes like big decisions for the school, and do you decide field trips?
It is the people that decide like stuff about the school. Like, they're the people that decide all the school rules and stuff like that.
What do you think about that? I mean, it sounds kind of like a big job.
Yeah, it is a pretty big job. I've seen like what they do, and it's pretty cool.
They volunteer. So they don't really get paid. It's kind of shocking that they don't get paid, but like, it's good that they're volunteering, you know?
They do so much for us, and like for the students, I guess.
I think that that's really nice of them, especially since, like, I just think it's really nice because a lot of people don't take the time to do that in their day, and a lot of people don't care that much about other people.
I like how they all like make a decision by listening to each other's ideas and correcting each other's ideas.
Keep doing that if you want like the world to be a good place, and maybe that might encourage some kids when they grow up to be a teacher too.
Thank you for the amazing ideas and rules you've come up with, and I hope that you guys keep on having fun with your job and make very good decisions.
Gracias, Medford School Board!